today, I show you a harder way of adding two numbers together. Today, we're going to be playing about with JavaScript. We're going to be looking at the basics of what it can do, some ideas of how you can integrate it into Mac specifically, and then the world is your oyster. You can do almost anything you want. Now, the amazing thing about JavaScript is exactly that its possibilities are essentially unlimited. However, disclaimer, the JavaScript object, JS, etc., is a really low priority executable in the Mac's sort of workflow. So although everything will get executed and it will receive all its outputs in the order that we create them, they cannot be used for time-sensitive operations if it is under a lot of load. Otherwise, things will just not happen when you need them to. With that out of the way, let's move on to the show. So here, we can add two numbers together, two integer boxes, a button, and we have a pretty little add object. But I find that really boring. So how can we make it harder for ourselves? I mean, how can we do it in JavaScript? Simple thing we need to do is save our patch. So I'm going to save this as, I'm going to make a new folder and call it JavaScript lesson magic. And I'm going to call this JavaScript master. Your Mac's patch name doesn't matter. And then, using your text editor of choice, I'm going to use Sublime here. You can literally use text or notepad if you want. I'm going to make a new file here and I'm going to call this Dropbox. I'm going to go to my Macs. And then in here, I created something called JavaScript lesson. And I'm going to call this lessonfile.js. Sublime's going to realize I'm in JavaScript and perfect. So now I can create a .js file and link it to lessonfile.js. And the Max, let me clear that, we don't need to see that. That was from when I was practicing. So now this is linked together with our JavaScript file over here. I'm also gonna add a compile message to that, so we can get any errors just in case I make spelling mistakes. And if you've watched any of my previous tutorials, you will know that, boy oh boy, am I good at spelling. So let's do some JavaScript. So, the general way that this works is that everything has to be in a function. So we're going to make a new function inside our JavaScript called function math test. I'm going to give it two variables, a and b, i.e. my two numbers. And these are going to be set inside our curly brackets. What do we want to do with this? We're going to declare two local variables, which is input one. That's going to be equal to A. Input one is equal to A. And then I'm going to create input two, which is equal to B. And like any object in Max, when you're passing information, it's going to read object A and then object B, separated by a comma. So all we need to do is pass it two numbers using something like the pack message, and it will automatically understand and break these down together. So now we can do, we've got two variables here. We're going to create another variable that is our output. I'm just going to call this output one for the sake of this. Input one plus input two, semicolon, and then surprise, surprise, outlet is the command to pass information to the Max outlet. Zero, all information starts, so it goes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 rather than 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to pass out the first outlet, and the information I'm going to pass is just our output number, forward followed by a semicolon. So I'm just going to quickly add some comments here. So double slash, some quick maths in Max. So now, reading this through, I've got a new function called maths test that uses variables A and B, and in here we declare internal variables that take A and B and then allow us to manipulate them, create an output variable, and then we output it through outlet 0, so it means the first outlet. So now we need to work out how to actually get Max to reference this. So I'm going to save it. I'm going to cut and paste our JavaScript file and double click it. And this will load in the Max editor, and you'll see that everything we need is there. So now, to access the function math test, I need to pass JS the message math test, and to do that I'm going to prepend math test, and then I'm going to pack two numbers together. So what do we have coming out of here? This will make sense when you see it. So now we have a message that says math test 613. So this is going to be passed into our JavaScript file. Almost like a root command, it's going to look for math test as a function. When it finds it, it's then going to assign a to 6, b to 13. This is then going to become 6, that's going to become 13. Variable output 1 is going to become 6 plus 13. And then we're going to output the result of output 1 on the outlet. So, for those of you that are maths geniuses, 6 plus 13, that's going to give us 19. So let's test. Plug that into the top there, give us a new output message. Magic. So now we're doing maths outside of Max itself, and it's all being worked through the JavaScript file because Max can natively understand it with the addition of the new commands such as outlet. But having things connected is really boring. So in a very similar way to send and receive objects, we can command them with JavaScript files. So I'm going to do r output 1, connect that to an outlet, a message. And then I'm going to change our code quickly and just say mess named. So what that's saying, it's going to pass a message named output 1. And all I'm going to do, very much like the output, is I'm going to the outlet, I'm going to say send it output 1. Save that. Cut and paste that. The reason I'm cutting pasting is I can't work out how to get the JS file to automatically compile for me. It seems to be playing really silly. You see, if I compile, it says I can't find it when I know it actually is working, because obviously it's giving us results. So for the sake of this, just make sure you cut and paste your JS object, and it will update every time. So now if I pass this 6 and I pass it 13, you'll see that output 1 is now receiving 19 as well. So you can start doing really complex calculations or matrix manipulations and then sending them without the need for wires and cables everywhere, just through some simple code. So if you've come from a coding background, much like I did when I started Max, I find this much more usable and easier to understand, because it's an executable sort of path you're used to.